brace yourselves, folks! We're doing another episode on gender issues. Won't that be fun? In fairness, this is an episode that looks at both sides, appeals for calm, and is rational and responsible. But, you know, just in case. Ugh.
Dragon's Crown has been at the centre of a controversy lately, and it's been an interesting one. Jason Schreier at Kotaku recently criticised the game's character design, chiefly that of the sorceress, for the focus on gigantic breasts and physics-shattering ass protrusions. Schreier wrote the designs off as something designed by a 14-year-old boy, and the artist, George Kamitani, responded by drawing a picture of naked burly dwarves and implying that Jason might like that more if he wasn't into the women. Frankly, rashness prevailed on both sides, as it so often does. Trier could have made a far better point without the insinuation, and Kamitani could have claimed more high ground by not resorting to the rather tired, lol big burly men for you lol retort. Cue mudslinging, venom, and attacks from both sides, be they for or against Vanillaware's designs. But then, that's one of the major issues crippling any discussion of gender in games right now. Nobody can have a fucking discussion about it. They can only have arguments. Jimquisition's tackled gender in games a few times, and each time I've tried to stress the need for discussion, for an exchange of ideas, for understanding, as opposed to a war over boobs. I think the gender issues hitting games are good for the medium, and there's a wealth of positivity to be mined from it, and I think there's potential for the gaming community to be so much more inclusive and welcoming and ultimately healthier. But only if we put down our swords and sit round the table, and that goes for everyone involved. The gender discussion right now seems to be a contest as to which side can harass the other the most on social networks, who can shout accusations or levy nasty threats the hardest. Dragon's Crown's mess utterly typified that. There was room for a great debate over the differences between sexualization and sexuality, of crafting characters that are sexy but not objectified, of what makes a character design satirical as opposed to simply titillating. For the record, and I speak only for myself as I can't arrogantly presume to speak for any women or men other than myself, I don't like the designs of the sorceress and Amazon. I find them kind of unsettling. The Amazon in particular looking all lumpy and clumpy, like she evolved from whatever race Krang off Turtles is a member of. At the same time, I understand the intent to riff off the old fantasy designs seen in Dungeons & Dragons and Conan the Barbarian, and I get Vanillaware's decision to exaggerate those designs to ludicrous proportions. Then again, I understand that in an industry utterly dominated by stereotypical designs of overmuscled men and ass-thrusting, boob-laden women, more of the same, even exaggerated, kind of fails to be ironic, especially when gamers, men or women, who want something else have so very few alternatives when it comes to female avatars in games. It's either play a game with maniacal, wobbly breasts, or replay Beyond Good and Evil for the 15th fucking time. That imbalance is one of the key reasons why games like Dragon's Crown make some people roll their eyes. We already discussed a few weeks ago how the game industry is deliberately trying to cull female protagonists, so it's doubly unsettling when that knowledge is accompanied by the message that playable women have to look like they exist solely for the purpose of popping boners. What's really interesting about Dragon's Crown, though, is that it does have an example of a sexy character that's not sexualized, and I'd love for there to be a discussion about that too. The elf is sensibly clothed, more reasonably proportioned, and any skin shown at least makes sense within the context of the character's role. I think it's a very sexy design, personally, and it's able to be so without resorting to the frankly unimaginative protrusion of massive boobs and bumholes. It takes real talent to make a sexy character that doesn't go for half nudity and exposed mammos, and I think the elf is an example of Kamitani's talent really shining through. But again, that's just me speaking for me and what I like. But to the boob wars again, it's funny that after Jason and George fired their shots, they started speaking, and both ended up quite reasonable. Jason apologized for his initial insult, George apologized for a ham-fisted response, and then went on to explain the reasoning for his character designs in a thoughtful and intelligent way that I found quite interesting, even if I didn't quite like the designs in question. You see what happens when people discuss things? When we're not trying to one-up each other in one-liner contests, when we're not flinging shit at each other, and we're actually acknowledging that some people like things and some people don't, I feel gamers can have some really great, provocative discussions. Then again, we're still trying to get over the fact that some people bought one game console and not another, so I guess we've still got a lot of groundwork to lay.
The thing that really upsets me about the fights that are going on is, I'm an ignorant man, I fully admit that. There's a lot I don't know. There's a lot I try to learn. In my early years writing for Destructoid and around the web, I wrote a lot of ignorant, some would even say, and they wouldn't be that wrong, but some would even say sexist shit. And at the time, I thought it was okay. I didn't realize it was a problem. And I didn't really appreciate the problems until someone calmly and rationally told me the problems. And all these fights that go on when gamers get angry and start throwing mud at anyone who points out a problem in the game industry, when that happens, the discussion dies, and when the discussion dies, we don't learn anything. And that kind of learning is stuff I've thrived on, stuff that's made me a better writer, a better commentator, a better video producer, and I think it makes the industry a better place. So let's talk, let's discuss, let's get something ruddy bloody done. Thank God for me. Hit the microphone again. That's gonna sound terrible. It's gonna sound absolutely terrible.